grades everybody in?
I'm first.
Okay.
Third. Any of you like any 11?
They look old enough. I think they do. Teenagers.
You're in kindergarten? Shallow thought you were like a fourth grade. You sure?
We want to thank everyone for coming tonight. It's been a wonderful night, and it's just so joyous, and all the children that are here, and we're really honored and everything for you all to come over here and let us talk to you one more time and read a story, okay? Do y'all like stories?
Yeah. For all the children inside. For all the children inside.
Commissioner O'Reilly?
Yes, ma'am.
We have a very special story for you tonight that the First Lady and Governor are going to read together. First Lady.
You notice that we're having to wear glasses too.
I have glasses. Oh.
And the print's really big.
'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse.
The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas would soon be there.
I'm not doing my job, I am. Let's do this so you can see. Okay. The children were nestled all snug in their beds while visions of sugar plums danced in their head.
And Mama, with her kerchief and I in my cap, had settled down for a long winter's nap.
When out on the lawn there rose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter.
Ooh. Away to the window, I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters, and threw up the sash.
The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below.
When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer.
With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick.
More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name.
Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donder and Blitzen.
On the top of the porch, on the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all.
As the dry leaves before, the wild hurricanes fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky.
So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew, with sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too.
And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof.
Okay, I missed a page. My page didn't say that. Okay, Kent, I think you skipped over.
Maybe
page. I'm going to say this. I'm going to keep up on the story. Yeah. Okay, y'all listen to me. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. Now I'm reading my part. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack.
Here you are.
Okay, I'm back. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry, his cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry.
His cruel little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and his beard on his chin was as white as snow. Now I'm gonna read the first lady's part now, like she does. The stump was a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke was enriched his head like a wreath.
He's making fun of me, God.
He had a broad face and a little round belly. Probably like me. Mine is a big round belly. That shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly.
He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself.
A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread.
He spoke not a word, but he went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk.
And laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod up the chimney, he rose.
He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like down of a thistle.
But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, "Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
Yay! Yay. Did you all get your books? Did everybody get a book?
Yes.
Well, we still have some more, so we'll make sure you get one before you leave, okay? Thank you so much for coming.
Y'all did so good.
Thank you all.
Y'all were wonderful. Wonderful.